Understand why this keeps happening. You don't deserve it. My love, you deserve better, and what's meant to be will be. Just think positive, and you know, you'll get through it. Love you too.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Married to Reality. It's, of course, the Darcey and Stacey edition. I'm your co-host, John, here with my wife and co-host, the one and only, Teresa.
Hello, everyone. How's everyone doing? Hold on.
Oh, yeah.
Did you change the intro music?
No, but I was thinking just now that I should. Why?
Because I feel like it's different.
I don't think so. No. You just didn't hear it last time because we were recording remotely.
Oh, maybe. It always cracks me up, and it still cracked me up, but I was like, wait a minute, is it different?
Uh-oh. Are you getting too used to it? Are you over it?
I will never be over it.
I was thinking, just listening now, I was like, there were so many good one-liners or two-liners this episode. I should just make it, the theme is manifested. The theme is angelic. The theme is 11, never say 11. Never.
This episode was out of control. If I had to summarize it in three words, mm-hmm. it would be pageant.
Yes.
Miami.
Yes.
Manifesting.
That's the episode, folks. Thanks for listening. We'll talk to you guys soon. No, yeah. I mean, I love this show. You know I love this show. You guys know I love this show. This was the first episode where I LOL'd hard. A lot of times I'll be like, that's funny. This time I was like, wait, I have to pause. I don't know what's happening. I'm laughing so hard. I couldn't take it in the best way possible.
He literally like died laughing as I was dying laughing. He's like, what is this shit?
It was so good. You said, if your dad knew what we were actually watching, he would have us committed.
Just for you guys, John's dad is a therapist.
We'll see. There we go. We pulled back the curtain all the way. How many episodes did it take to pull back the curtain?
What do you mean?
Because every episode I'm like, we have a therapist in the family. We're pro family. Oh. You know, because I kind of shit on sometimes a lot of people that go to therapy because you guys have been dating for 3 months and you need to see a therapist. It's like, no, you got to see other people. That's who you need to see.
Yeah.
And so I'm always like, there's a therapist in the family. We're pro therapy. And now you're like, John's dad.
Well, I'm sure some people would put it together. When right. I said your dad would literally be like, WTF, are you two watching?
My biggest hope, now that the cat's out of the bag, my biggest hope was that when Darcey was going to see a therapist in the first season,
that
she rolled into my dad's office. And because patient confidentiality, he would not be able to share that with us. So I was like, come on. But of course, not.
I would love it. I think that would be probably my favorite thing ever.
Oh my gosh. I don't think he would take her on as a patient.
Oh, he would.
Would he?
I feel like your dad would love to study.
Oh, he would love to psychoanalyze that.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Anyways, guys, it's the Darcey and Stacey podcast. We are here. We cannot wait to get into it, and we will. Before we do, couple things we always ask. We're not going to stop now. Make sure you guys follow us on social media. A lot of you guys are coming on over. A lot of new faces we're seeing. That's awesome. You can find us at Married to Reality Pod on Instagram. All the good stuff is happening there. The memes, the news. You can message us. You can talk to us. If you have a question for my dad, let us know. I'll ask him and I'll come back to you with the answers free of charge. So do that on Instagram at Married to Reality Pod. Also, make sure you guys are following the podcast wherever you're listening. So easy to do. Just look down and smash that follow button.
Guys, smash the like is as hot as this Miami trip.
Woo!
Because the girls cannot stop talking about it.
No, and we got a tease. We got a little glimpse of it. And it looks like it's going to be H-O-double-T
hot. Yeah. And don't forget about our merch store.
Ah, well, you love to plug it. And second of all, you love to skip ahead and plug it.
Oh, because, did I skip something?
Well, the reviews are nice. You know?
Damn.
You know, okay. That's something you can do for us for free. Teresa wants you to spend that cash.
I mean, you don't need to. You can check it out. And if you like it, you can.
And also, let's throw this out here and message us on Instagram at Married to Reality Pod. We got a couple fun shirts. We got a couple logo shirts. We got some things. If there's something you want to see that's not in the store, let us know. If it's a quote Teresa says a lot, or something you just hear that you'd like to see on a shirt or a mug, let us know.
Yeah, let us know. We're all ears. Let us know. We're not going to promise that we'll make it. But we might. We may. Exactly.
And here's a promise. If you give us an idea and we run with it, we'll give you a big discount, maybe free. Maybe.
Look at that.
Look at me.
I wish you were running these ideas by me because you always caught me off guard.
Well, if you come up with a great idea that we're going to put in our store, I think they deserve a little something from it.
I wish we could do Max mugs.
We do mugs.
As cool as the one I'm holding right now. But that would be too difficult.
Well, now tell them. Sometimes you say things and I'm like, you're really taking us down a path that we don't need to go down. And then I think, maybe she wants to go down that path. So go down the path. Let's go.
I just have a beautiful mug with dinosaurs.
I always feel the need to tie it back because I feel like we got to provide value to these people and they just don't want to hear us ramble on about our personal lives and what our dads do for work. But we got that mug in Connecticut.
We did.
It sort of ties to the Silva sisters. Mm-hmm. So there you go.
There you go.
There you go. Okay. That is it. Please leave a review if you haven't. And I think that's the end of the housekeeping.
I think so. I think you cleaned the house.
We cleaned the house. We can sell this house now. Like, Daddy, Father Mike.
Oh, I can't believe he's selling the house.
I know, but have you seen the new house?
No, you have?
Oh, yeah.
How?
My mom's a real estate agent.
Wait a minute,
I'm
what?
Not kidding, but no, but it was on the interwebs, the photos. It's an incredible structure.
Wait, again, did you see it on Instagram? Speak English to me.
I don't know. I saw it on like people.com or something.
Oh.
It's quite a spread.
So is it on like the magazine about famous peeps?
The Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous?
People.com. Isn't it People magazine?
Yeah. Okay. I don't know if it was that exact magazine, but it was something similar.
I'm trying to get to the bottom of this.
Yeah, I saw a photo. I'll show you a photo.
Is it in Middletown?
I don't know where it is exactly. Mm. They didn't dox Darcey. They didn't give us her address, but they have a couple of photos up there, and it's their old house, whatever you want to call it, their current house, their old house. Very nice. Mm-hmm. This is like 10 times that.
What?
Yeah, it's crazy.
Good for Mike.
And I think Darcey and Stacey are paying a little bit.
And Florian and Georgi, they're probably not paying. They're probably going to, all of them, move in with Mike.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, I mean, we'll get to it, but did you hear that Darcey, Stacey, their husbands, and their kids all used to live in that house?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh, for sure.
And you wonder why the marriages didn't work out? Can you imagine that?
No.
It's ridiculous. That's not a good idea, guys.
Listen, I always love when we visit our parents and when we do and they take care of us. We always think, oh my gosh, can we live here? Mm-hmm. But I'm sure that eventually we both are pretty private people and we like our privacy. So we would probably get a little tired of the constant, what do you call it? The constant contact with other human beings.
Not a sponsor. Constant contact, not a sponsor. But yeah, it's a little too much, I think. Let's get into it. Let's talk about episode 3. Okay?
Let's do it.
A lot happens, and it starts with pageant day.
Before the pageant.
A new spinoff.
Today is the day. The Teen Connecticut Pageant.
Okay.
And we learned something about Georgi because He came to support Aniko and obviously Darcey, the pageant mom, the official pageant mom.
Oh my gosh.
And Georgi apparently has some experience with pageants.
He used to help
organizing pageants in Bulgaria, and then he organized his own pageant. And guess what? It was the biggest pageant in Bulgaria.
Biggest in Bulgaria. So he knows. He knows the importance of pageants, this guy. Here's what threw me off about Georgi. Thought he was showing a little too much chest around 14-year-olds.
Was he?
He was buttoned down to the belly button.
Yeah, it was fine.
That was the only button he had buttoned was his belly button.
That was fine.
It was fun. There's 13-year-old, 14-year-old girls wandering around, and here's this...
wandering around in bathing suits, please.
Exactly. And you have this, however old he is, Bulgarian model showing his completely waxed chest.
That's just his style.
You're into it. I know you're a little turned on. It is his style, but just there's a time and a place. I mean, there are rules to this pageant, and we learn there are rules, and thank goodness there are rules, because one of the rules is Darcey's not allowed backstage.
And I think that's smart.
And I don't think it's moms aren't allowed backstage. I think it's Darcey's not allowed backstage.
You know what struck me a little? You know how the sisters always dress up, and they dress up when they go to see the psychologist, and they dress up when they go to the supermarket?
Yes.
Why didn't they do their hair when they're at this pageant? They literally put it in a bun, but it wasn't a messy bun, like, oh, that's a cool messy bun. It was the bun you put your hair in when you take a shower.
Oh, see, I didn't know. I was too distracted by Georgie's glistening chest.
I don't even know how to react to that.
Was it not a tight bun, like a high and tight? Because that's like a dancer's bun. And this reminded me of a dance recital.
Oh, no, there was a messy bun, but not the good messy bun. Listen, I'm a sucker for a good bun.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm good at buns.
Sticky buns, cinnamon buns, all sorts of buns.
All sorts of buns.
Yeah, buns of fun.
Those type buns were buns. Just these, ugh, I gotta take a quick shower buns.
Oh, well, maybe they were in a hurry. Maybe they were in a
that's
rush.
Literally what it looked like. So I was so surprised that they're hitting this pageant with their hair looking like that.
No, that's good. It means they spent time on Aniko instead of themselves, because this is about Aniko.
It is, yes.
As much as it can be when your mom is Darcey. So then Stacey and Florian arrive. Apparently the lamb worked, because now there's peace between everyone.
Yeah, Stacey is glad to see Georgi supporting Darcey and Aniko. And then Mike shows up, and I don't know if he's very thrilled, but...
Mike got the memo, but he didn't read the memo because... they're all wearing, all the men are wearing white shirts. Mike's showing zero chest, though, because Georgie's showing a lot of chest. Florian, white button down, showing a fair amount of chest. Mike, just a white undershirt, if we're going to do outfits the segment a little bit. But I found it comical. They're all wearing white, and Mike's not showing it. He's not giving anything away for free.
I think the dress code changes a little once you hit like 65.
Yeah, American hats all the time, because every piece of headwear he wore had an American hat. But yeah, he could get away with not dressing up so spiffy. He wasn't the spiffiest of the bunch.
Mike is looking good. He's looking good.
I know. You keep your pants on over there.
Imagine looking like Mike when you turn that age. Oof.
Oh, yeah?
I'm going to be dropping my pants.
Oh, hello.
Or my diaper. I don't know.
Jeez. How old do you think he is?
I don't know.
All right. Let's talk about this pageant, because it's no joke. This thing looked like the finale of American Idol.
Mm-hmm.
Right? There was lights, lasers, fog, maybe. It was something to see. I mean, this is Connecticut, folks, so this is probably as big as it gets. We're not known for our pageantry.
But Connecticut is the posh state. That's what I call it.
That's what you think.
You guys have so many fancy, rich towns.
We have a handful.
And then you have Yale. You have New Haven.
Yale is very posh.
You have Stanford. Greenwich.
New Haven's not posh. Yale is the gem. Yale is the diamond in the rough.
Basically, Yale is New Haven. There's nothing else to New Haven.
That's not true. We just didn't take you to those parts. Where my parents grew up in New Haven, and I mean, they grew up in a fine area, but it's anywhere USA.
Well, if you think of New Haven, you think of Yale, and I think, and the Peabody Museum.
Right. Shout out to where you got your mug. Okay. So all the girls come out. Aniko is doing her thing. I think she looked great.
Oh, she looked amazing. Fantastic. But I have to say how powerful makeup is. Not that she's not beautiful without makeup.
Yeah, looked so mature.
Yes, that was my point. She's a very pretty girl with or without makeup. But with makeup, she looked like she's like 24,
yeah, model-esque.
25. Yeah.
Model-esque. Really aged her up, but in a good way. She still looked great. Her energy was good. I felt good about it. There was a point
You felt good about it.
I felt good about
That's important. Yeah. How many pageants did you help
out
with?
I would have felt bad because I'm not a person who is a big fan of makeup. I'm not a person who's a big fan of very fancy hair, right? I like you when you're in jeans and a tee, no makeup, hair down, or in a ponytail. So I felt good. Like, she put all this time and this work into it. She did her hair, she did her makeup, and she actually looked just as good, if not better, than when she's just in sweats. So I felt good that all the hard work paid off.
Well, I don't think she did the makeup and the hair, but whoever did it.
Great job. Okay. My favorite part of this scene was during the evening gown portion of the competition. There was this point where Georgi looks at Darcey, looks at Stacey, and then puts his arms around both of them.
I saw that.
Because I don't think he knew who was who. And he's like, okay, I guess I'll just go with both.
That's a good point. I just thought he was going to be like, oh, my girl. My girl's twin.
There's no reason to put your arm around Stacey. It's not like her kid's in the pageant. I think he was confused, and I don't blame him. All the lights, the fog, the good-looking young girls. He was probably just out of it, you know, a little disoriented.
I can see that. Yeah, I mean, the move was good.
That was
a good move.
That was the first time I laughed. I was like, this guy doesn't know who Darcey is.
But Darcey's very proud of Aniko. Of course she is. And she's like, she got it from her mama.
Of course.
And Stacey. And her auntie.
Yeah. I'm glad she didn't. Darcey, I'm going to say this with peace and love. I'm glad she didn't get it from you. And I hope she doesn't go your way. Because she's doing so good right now. So pretty. So smart. Such positive energy. Just stay on that path.
Yeah, Darcey's very happy. She just called her mini-me.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, I think you always want your kid to best you. I think you want your kid to surpass you. And I think Aniko's already done that. So I hope she continues to do that.
I guess.
You always want your kids to do better than you. No matter how good you do, you want your kids to do better than you.
Of course you do. But I feel like it's also different if the kid does something that you don't even know what it is. If you don't know anything about. Doesn't make any sense?
No.
Like, I know my parents are proud of me and everything, but what they do is very different from what I do. So it's not like surpassing them.
No. But having as good, if not a better life, it's not a competition. I'm not saying like, oh, if your dad's a therapist, you have to be a better therapist. I'm saying, no, if your dad got a good education and has a happy marriage and makes a decent living, that you have all that and more. Like, you set your kids up to do even better than you.
Of course. That makes sense.
So speaking of doing better, let's get to the results of this pageant, because they didn't totally go Aniko's way, but she won Miss Photogenic,
which is great.
Yeah, she didn't win the whole thing, but she got a buckle. She won a buckle. If we're gonna compare this to pig royalty, she got a prize. And
eyes on the prize
snatched.
Snatched.
I wish you guys could see when Theresa does this.
I wish I could see myself too.
She scares herself with her own fist. You literally look terrified as your fist is coming at your face to snap.
To snatch.
So, okay. Aniko wins Miss Photogenic.
Woohoo!
She goes out to get all of her flowers. It reminded me of my dance recitals.
It reminded me of when I won Miss Spa.
You did? They didn't give you like an asthma machine?
I didn't have asthma.
You went to breathing camp.
Yeah, that was the spa. Let's go to the spa camp.
Okay.
The spa camp?
Sure, we'll posh it up for you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for my free discipline, I sung a song and I danced a little.
And you won?
I did.
Yeah, it's because the other kids couldn't breathe and they probably couldn't get a note out. They're like, oh, she got a note out. Give it to her. Give it to her. She got her note out.
I was like 12, 13. Mm, yeah.
Yeah. Nice.
Good times. Nice. Good times.
Okay. So she wins Miss Photogenic. She gets the flowers. Everyone's so happy. But did you see Aspen? Did you see how she looked? Because she looked pissed.
Why?
Oh, she's just standing there in the background. She has the meanest mug on her face. She is so not happy that Aniko won.
I don't think so.
Oh, I know
so.
They're
our sisters.
Oh, I don't care. Oh, and Darcey and Stacey aren't in competition?
Well, that's
where do
different.
You think they learn it?
I think if you have a twin.
No.
You have this need to compete. But no. With someone like, they look different.
I know.
Aniko is young. I mean, Aspen is younger. So if Aspen wants to do this, she can do it next year.
And
I'm
I think
sure.
she will. I think she saw that and was like, it's my turn to shine. It's my turn. Because, hey, we can roll the tape back. I can show you. She was not pleased. She was not having it.
Well, I don't Aniko, see that.
I know you didn't look, clearly. There's no way you could see the way Aspen's face was and think, oh, yeah, she's happy. For Aniko.
Have you ever been jealous of your sister?
No, but I think that's different. I think brothers and sisters have different passions and goals. And so that's different. I think these are both two young, pretty girls. Aspen does probably want to get in the pageant game. And
well, she could have. I think the pageant, as you said, is 14 to 19. Aspen is 15. She could have joined the pageant if you wanted to, she wanted to.
I think maybe she will.
We'll see.
Yeah. I mean, I was jealous of my sister when she got a car, when she got her license, when she could go party and drink. And
she's
I couldn't.
4 years older than you.
Yeah.
So, when so she you was, got there too.
No,
you
I know. And maybe Aspen.
There's no reason to be jealous.
Maybe a lot of people are jealous before their time. Like they're jealous and they'll eventually get whatever they wanted, but you're jealous when you don't have it.
I guess.
Yeah, you guess. You're an only child. You don't know.
Yeah, but no one ever gave me a car.
Oh, that's true. Okay. New day. Stacey and Borian getting dressed for a Miami theme party. Deb and Reina, they're throwing them this party to celebrate their acceptance to Miami Swim Week.
And Stacey's trying to force Borian into wearing this flower shirt. Just Miami, baby. Miami, baby. And Borian is like not having it. He's like, Stacey, no, I don't like it. No,
like
no.
Garden guy. I don't want to look like garden guy.
I love when Borian talks.
Everything he says.
Whatever
understand?
Comes out of him is golden.
Yeah. And then Stacey spoke and it was hilarious. She's like, come on, lighten up. Let's play a little fun game before we go out tonight. Pop quiz. What's the name of the state Miami's in? And Borian's response is so good because he's so not having it. He's so not into it. But under his breath, he's just like, Florida, Stacey, I don't want to do pop quiz. It's like he answers it. He needs to answer it to prove that he knows. But in the same breath, he's like, Florida, Stacey, I don't want to do the pop quiz.
But I have to say, I think for some reason, some strange reason, they are happy together. And I think they're together all the time, as Borian will tell us later.
24/7.
24/7. And I think it works for them.
Yeah. I think Stacey is infatuated with Florian. And Florian doesn't have a chance to get out from under her.
I think he truly loves her. Mm. I really do.
I don't know about that, but
no one's holding him hostage.
His circumstances are holding him hostage.
No, he can go back.
He could go back to Albania.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's what he wants. I think he likes America. I think he likes his newfound fame.
I think he likes Stacey. I truly do.
Okay. We'll see. We'll see if they...
Listen, we're together 24-7 basically too. You never shave my legs. You never put bronzer on me.
You never ask me to.
Because it's ridiculous.
It's a little... You could do that yourself.
I would love for you to put a bronzer on me though. But not in our apartment.
Okay.
Probably outside.
All right. We'll look into that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
mm-hmm.
Next question. Easy question. How many states are in America?
Not that easy.
Not that easy for Stace. She's like, Borian goes, I don't know. And Stacey's like, I'm not going to take no for an answer. And Borian's like, I don't know, Stace. And Stacey goes, 51. 51 states.
Oh, Stacey. Someone failed geography.
The producer goes, Stacey, how many states are there? And Stacey doubles down. It's like, 51. And then she realizes... the error of her ways.
And she's like, Puerto Rico? Puerto, like, nah.
Puerto Rico? I'm going to give it to her. That's a good, if you're going to guess 51 and Puerto Rico's your reasoning, that's not bad. Because they
have to do the U.S. Virgin Islands and blah, well, there's yada, been talk, yada, yada.
There's been talk of making Puerto Rico a state. So that's good. The common wrong answer is 52.
Really? Why?
I think people conflate deck of cards with number of states. And so a lot of people will say 52.
I've never heard it. No. I did hear 51 from people.
But I've never heard 51.
It's 50 and Puerto Rico is not a state.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And D.C. is not a state either. And I think some people.
It's a district.
It's a district of Columbia.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to D.C.
Someone graduated high school. Like in Czech, we do this special test that you have to do the Czech language. You have to do a foreign language. So I did Czech, I did English. And then I did philosophy and geography. Mm-hmm. And basically you study for it your whole year. It's like the equivalent of the ACT?
SAT.
SAT.
They do have ACTs, yeah. But no, they have both.
So that's the equivalent of how we graduate high school. Doesn't give us a right to college. We have to pass more exams. But anyways, it's a big thing. We study for it. I picked geography as one of mine.
Mm-hmm.
I had to study the whole world. I had to prepare 45 questions, studied. Each question had like 10 to 15 pages. Studied hard. Fun fact, I picked the USA out of a freaking ball.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That worked out
well.
And
I've been here before. And I freaking love maps. That's like something I do for fun. I look at maps. I'm not even joking.
What a blast.
It is a blast. I'm fascinated by maps. But anyways, I freaking nailed it. So I know a lot about America.
Yeah. Oh, I am not being facetious. I have a feeling by the time you get your citizenship, which won't be too long now, I think you'll know more about America and American history than a lot of Americans.
Oh, for sure.
Because they're going to test you. They're going to ask you the hard questions.
And it was one of my notes saying, Borian better start studying this stuff because if he wants to become a citizen, that's definitely one of the easier questions.
Yeah, and don't study with Stacey, Florian. Find a better study buddy because you'll fail. Okay, let's go from D.C. to D.G. Let's go to Darcey and Georgi. They're in the car and they're heading to meet up with everyone at Relish, the hottest club in Connecticut.
Wasn't it Deb's backyard?
It was the backyard of Relish Rest Bar and Grill.
Oh, I thought it was Deb's backyard.
It looked like that. That's how we get down in Connecticut.
I like it.
Yeah. So before they go in, Georgi and Mike, they're going to have a little talk, a little heart to heart. And Georgie's like, oh, it's hot today. Well, hot, Mike, wouldn't you say? Just making small talk, uncomfortable small talk. And he's like, yeah, so me and Darcey, we've had a lot of ups and downs, but we went to couples counseling and it's actually helped. And Mike's like, wow, that's great. You're taking the steps. That's good. You need to put the effort in, the both of you.
50-50.
50-50. And then he made some analogy, which I didn't even write down because I didn't understand it.
Well, he said, not the analogy, but basically, long story short, he said that Mike knows that Georgi has to bond with Aniko and Aspen as well as with Darcey because they come in a pack. And apparently Mike's ex-wife, or he said his most recent wife, which I'm going to assume it's an ex-wife, did not get along with Darcey and Stacey, so
it ended.
It ended. And of course it's important. Like, the woman has kids. She adores her kids. She comes in a pack. So he has to get along with them. Not necessarily to become their father, because we heard that the dad is in the picture, right? And then Mike is in the picture.
Absolutely.
But be a friend. Just be nice.
I didn't get where this was coming from, though, because there's never been a point in this story where Georgie's been out of the picture or aloof or not wanting to deal with the girls.
No, he's actually great with the girls from what we've seen.
Right.
But Mike meant that if Georgi only focuses on Darcey, that's not going to be enough. He has to focus on Darcey, but on her girls too.
Is it that, or is Mike almost saying, look, Darcey is so distracted by TV, so distracted by House of 11, so distracted by Miami Swim Week. Like, we need you to kind of focus on the girls and get Darcey to focus on the girls.
Yeah, I don't think that's what he was saying. There's no issue with
Georgi and the girls.
No, but I think he spoke from his own experience saying, hey, I had a wife. She didn't like my kids. Didn't work out.
Yeah. No, it's definitely important.
Yeah.
You're a family. You got to get along.
And maybe Georgi doesn't, like, he talks to girls, I guess, but he doesn't try.
Mm.
But maybe Mike wants him to try more.
Mm. Yeah.
Who knows? We'll see.
Okay. So cut to everyone else. They're heading in to meet up with Deb and Reina. Darcey apologizes for the other night. Reina's like, I don't know if, you know, it needs an apology. It's just same shit, different day. And Darcey's like, yeah, but okay, I'm a little nervous. I wanted to apologize because I'm not sure if you got Georgie's RSVP, but he's coming. He's coming. And they're like, all right, well, we should probably start drinking then.
And so they did.
So they do. Georgi and Mike walk in. And then Stacey and Borian like peel in, horns honking, jackets waving. They know how to make an entrance. And with them, it's the return of Mother Nancy.
Hello, Nancy.
Hello, Nancy. Nancy. Looks like she pre-gamed this party.
Oh, yeah. And they did some wild dances.
Okay.
Stacey and Nancy.
They were acting like it was someone's bachelorette party.
Mm-hmm.
They were acting like it was spring break in Sandusky, Ohio. Right? What was?
I don't even know what to tell you about that reference.
Just imagine Danielle on spring break in Sandusky, Ohio. That's what this felt like.
I think Danielle would probably go to Maryland.
Ooh, to Ocean City with her girls. Yeah, it was out of control. It was the first time I noticed Reina had a big tattoo on her breast.
Does she?
Oh, she does.
I didn't notice.
And speaking of bad decisions, this is the first and only time I saw Reina drinking water the whole time.
Was she?
She was not drinking alcohol. She was not imbibing. She
Look
was sucking down water.
I mean, you live, you learn.
Do you think she saw herself on TV and was like, I need to make some changes for the third season?
Oh, it was really hot. She was hydrating.
Yeah. I didn't see her take one sip of alcohol. And I was like, that's suspicious, Reina.
Maybe it wasn't on camera, but we went to a 4th of July party at your coworker's house. It was so hot that most of the time I was drinking water not to get a headache.
So that's true.
I was mixing some booze in and out. Just in, not out. But I was drinking water a lot because it was hot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So. Alcohol, water. Alcohol, water. That's a recipe for a good day, a better night, and a decent morning.
Mm-hmm.
So,
well said.
Of course, the girls, they got to strut their stuff, right? Darcey and Stacey have to show their runway walk because we have an equally powerful, inspiring walk, and we're going to show it off. Swag slay, keep your eye on the prize, all of the motivation you need. They show their stuff off, and then they start doing Morse code. They're like, and I'm like, wait, what's happening? You guys speaking Morse code now? What are you guys doing? What is this? Is this music?
I love that you said it because I used to know the whole alphabet.
In Morse code?
Mm-hmm.
Therese, you impress me more every day.
I was a freaking tiny camper. I used to go to camp every year for 3 to 4 weeks.
Yep.
since I was 5.
This is not spa camp.
No, regular camps. I went to a spa camp. That was a different thing.
I was thinking like maybe you didn't have enough breath, so you could only communicate in Morse code.
No, like sleeping in tents, taking showers in the lake.
Camp. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I had my fair share of overnight camps.
Every year. And it was always, every year we had to learn. And then I was just like, fuck it. I'm just going to learn ahead so I can just shine. I don't have to keep learning at the camp.
And you
can just know it all.
You knew Morse code?
Mm-hmm.
You don't remember it at all?
Just a few letters. But
share with us. What are a few?
So A is nah.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I wish I could fact check you right
B
now.
B is Liskavice. So it's
Okay. Don't you think it would be like A is eh, B is
yeah, well,
that would be
then
easier.
You gotta do like Z is like
right 26. Yeah, good for you,
right?
Yeah, very impressive.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
That would be a good two truths and a lie.
It's funny. I was actually thinking of doing a tattoo in Morse code.
Mm-hmm.
Just my parents' name. I love them so much. Just their
not my name.
Just their initials.
Not my name.
Well, I love you, but I'm with you all the time.
True. Very true.
So, fun fact. Fun fact, guys.
Fantastic fact. All right. So, we find out they're going to be walking down the runway to their song, Doing It Big, Do It Big, whatever the title is. No one seems to know.
I think the title is We're Doing It Big.
Yeah. And so, Aniko's like, Do It Big. It's choogy. It's a little choogy.
A.K.A. What are they? We are millennials. Who are they?
I don't know. TikTokers? Too cool for me. I'll tell you that.
Too cool for me.
I don't know what choogy is.
But choogy means cringy. Like out of style.
Very like not trendy. Cool. Not trendy at all.
But when they started playing, or not even playing, singing their song, it was cringy. I was cringing because I thought, this is so bad. This is so bad.
Yeah.
They cannot sing. The song sucks. But apparently they always wanted to be recording artists.
The issue with them is they're jacks of all trades, masters of none. They don't focus on anything enough to actually be good at it. They're not focusing enough on their clothing line. They're not focusing enough on their music. They're not focusing enough on modeling. It's like, so you like dabble in it all and it's all pretty atrocious, but you think you guys are the best of the best at everything.
So I'm glad they are not focusing on their music. I think that's good for everyone.
Well, if they actually were interested in being musicians and singers and they truly focused on it, it would be better than it is.
So are you saying I can become a musician?
You could be better than them. That's for sure.
I think everyone can. I can be like,
hold on. I think a boat's trying to contact us. Yeah. Never give up. Never give up. All right.
Yeah, I'm sure that's one of their mottos.
Yeah, for sure. All right, guys, this may not be choogy, but we need to take a break and we'll be right back. All right, we are back. It's a new day. Darcey and Stacey are at Father Mike's because, as we said, Mike is selling his house so he can buy his dream home and retire.
And this was one of my favorite parts of this whole show.
Oh,
what's coming up?
Oh, yeah.
Just cracked me up.
I forgot
so
for a second.
Hard.
Okay, so the sisters are going through the old stuff of theirs to see what they want to keep because, as I said, they used to all live there as one big Silva bunch. And they want to, I guess, take some old things, which doesn't seem very Silva-like. You think they'd be like, out with the old, in with the new. Keep it tight. Snatched. You can't be snatched. Right. Right. But apparently they're going thrift shopping in their old house with
memories.
Their own stuff. Yeah. And so Mike comes in and they start talking about Miami. And this is the best 5 minutes of television I've seen in 2022.
I think we rewind it like 5 times at least. And we're just cracking up.
We had to make sure we got this down right.
So Mike is asking the girls about Miami. Like, so what's going on? So the theme is 11-11, angelic, light bright, and manifesting.
Yeah, that's all one theme, ladies? Like,
no, that's not it. That's not it.
That's half the theme. 11-11, angelic, light and bright, and manifesting.
Yes. So that's like the title.
Yes.
The tagline, 11-11, never give up, manifest your dreams. Because I'm a manifester, and she's a manifester too. Darcey talking about her and Stacey. And I learned that manifester is not a word.
It's not a word.
No, my iPad says, nope.
Not buying it?
Nope. It's all like underlined in red.
Your
like,
iPad needs to else. Learn to manifest then. Okay. Is it me when Stacey's like, the theme of the fashion show is 11-11, never give up. I'm like, are you guys biting 9/11 never forget. A little bit.
Oh my gosh.
That seems very close to 11/11 never give up.
Listen, you're going to hate this. You actually know. But then they said, when you see 11/11, close your eyes and make those dreams come true.
Yeah.
And I do it all the time.
You do it with more than 11/11.
I do it with every number.
10/10, 12/12.
Yeah.
Any double.
I'm manifesting any number that I see that's like, doo-doo.
Yeah. Well, has it worked?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Keep it up.
I mean, someone got promoted recently.
Oh, who? Me? Oh, mm-hmm. Were you manifesting for me?
Yeah, I was manifesting for you.
Can you manifest for another?
And once you get promoted, I'm manifesting for something else now.
Manifest on. Message us. Let us know if you want Teresa to manifest for you, because dreams come true.
I only have a minute. I have a big list I always go through.
Ooh.
And as things happen, I keep dropping them.
There might be an opening on the manifestation list if you guys want to holler at us. Okay, if you guys need some good thoughts, let us know. So, okay, we learn all about the themes, the very long themes. I think there's themes, then there's subtitles to this themes, and then there's who knows what else. It's very long, very long-winded. But Mike's like, all right, I think we need to talk business here. What's going on with the budget? He's like, you guys did this a couple of years ago, did a similar thing. You weren't very focused. You guys weren't manifesting hard enough. And you lost a lot of money doing this. And the business didn't really succeed.
Mm-hmm. Apparently, the Silva sisters went to LA to work, quotation marks. But they started spending money on luxurious cars, luxurious apartments, mm-hmm. shopping in LA. They basically overdosed.
Yeah. And Darcy's like, I do miss those luxurious cars. It's like you're driving matching Range Rovers.
Yeah. Well, what did you drive in LA that Mike paid for?
It had to have been convertibles, like
Lamborghini
Porsches.
Or.
Yeah. No, they couldn't have done it that big. It's doing it too big, I think. I'm going to say they had Porsches.
Mm.
I think. That's my guess. That's a nice car.
That's a nice car.
I'll take
for
the
sure.
Range. Anything.
Listen, I have a Hyundai, so.
Can you manifest a Range Rover for me?
Well, you have to work hard for it.
I'm working. I'm doing my part. You got to manifest.
We don't need the Range Rover.
We don't need, but it would be nice. Although I heard they're terrible cars.
Really?
Yeah, I heard they break down a lot.
Well, that's what I heard about a car I want to get.
A Jeep Wrangler.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I want to get a Jeep Wrangler and put the Jurassic Park tire on it.
Just manifest it. Okay. So Mike's like, you got to focus. He's concerned about the drama. He's nervous about Georgi and how that may impact the show. So he's being the business mind of this operation. Even though he's not going to invest, he's still concerned that everything works out.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So then we cut to Stacey and Borian at their apartment. Stacey's got the wax strips. She's ready to go. Apparently, it's in Borian's job description to wax Stacey, along with contouring her and bronzing her.
And shaving her.
Shaving her. Who knows what else? I'm glad they stopped there.
And that's why I think he really loves her.
Well, I don't know if he has an option.
Maybe that's his job, because Stacey always bashes Georgi for not working.
Mm.
Maybe this is what Borian does, because he goes like, hello, salons.
Like, what is he?
He said something about salons, like salons, hire me. Or
oh, understand?
Yeah. So maybe that's his job.
Right. Yeah, that's one of his chores around the house.
Mm-hmm.
So Stacey's like, I didn't get snatched to hide this body at home. I didn't get snatched to hide this body at home. So I'm getting ready to show it off in Miami. And Borian, he's not a big fan of her showing off her body. He doesn't want other people looking at her body, understand?
I do understand, yeah.
Does he understand that millions of people watch her on TV every week?
I'm sure he understands.
I don't know if he understands that she's putting all of this out. She's flashing the world while she's on a boat. She's running around a spa in Turkey, butt-ass naked, and millions of people are watching.
Maybe he doesn't understand.
I don't know if he understands. Because she's out there. She's putting it all out there.
I mean, she paid for it. She might as well.
Show it off. So then we learn there's a DJ. There's this guy, Michael, that's going to be meeting the girls in Miami. a DJ they met on a shoot years ago.
In LA.
In LA. They're going to have some business meetings. And Borian's not invited.
He's like, who the fuck is Michael? I never heard of him. Never heard of him.
I don't understand. Who's Michael? Yeah, he's not happy. And I don't... Let Borian go. Let Borian go to the meeting. He's homeless. What's he going to do? Right?
Yeah, let him go with you.
Your entourage. Everyone needs an entourage. Let Borian go. Let Georgi go.
Plus, I love how they call it a business meeting when they're going to meet a friend.
Mm-hmm. That's a good point.
If I showed up for my business meetings with my boobs out, that would probably be the last business meeting I would ever attend.
At least alone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But listen, Michael's their friend. Come on.
Yes.
Bring Florian.
We'll see. We'll see how this ends up. So then we cut to Darcey and Georgi. They're packing up at their place. And all I can say is Darcey has an entire suitcase of sunglasses.
I first thought that they're just trying to find the best pair to bring.
Oh, no, I immediately knew. And I don't know why I didn't think of this sooner or why it was so shocking. But I was like, oh, wow, yeah, she's going to travel with an entire suitcase of sunglasses.
And she made a comment how expensive that suitcase is.
She looked like the guy on the sidewalk in Times Square that's selling knockoff sunglasses.
Yes.
That I did purchase Folkleys from.
You did?
When I was like 16 years old. No, not when I was living there. When I would travel with my family. And I'd be like, Mom, Dad, like I know you're not going to buy me $200 Oakleys, but can I get these Folkleys? And then I would go.
Folkleys.
Yeah, fake Oakleys. And then I would go and I would buy them. And I thought I was the coolest kid in middle school. Yeah. But that was the guy. He's like, yeah, I got these.
Mm-hmm.
And then he would see a cop, he'd close it, and he'd run off. Like that's what Darcey looked like with that suitcase.
I can totally see that. Yeah, the last pair of sunglasses that you always steal from me, I get for $4 on Amazon, but I had a coupon.
You had a coupon?
Yeah, they were 15.
Well, get me a pair. I'll stop stealing them.
Yeah, mate. Yeah, Your birthday's coming up.
Get a whole suitcase of those things for like 25 bucks. Come on. So Darcey, she's packing up. She's looking forward to Miami because it's a special place in her and George's relationship. It's where they first met.
Mm.
So maybe they can get that spark back, that Miami spark. So it's go time. They say goodbye to Father Mike and they're off. And Darcey, she always looks like something special, but she looked like something special in this scene where they're out there dancing before they leave. She looked like an aging WWF wrestler. Right? She looked like the female version of Hulk Hogan with how blonde her hair was, how tanned she was, how leathery she was.
Is it the guy who catches criminals?
That's Dog the Bounty Hunter, but that's a fair shout too. Yeah. Dog the Bounty Hunter snatches people up. He's not snatched himself.
You know what caught me off guard a little?
Everything about this show?
Well, totally, but they were a traveling coach.
I know. I was going to point that out.
Right?
But I was like, is that a little snobbish of me?
No, it's not. Like, we travel. I feel like most people travel coach and it's great. Yeah. Like,
we're in the last row of all of our flights.
Yeah, why not? This is how we get deals. This is how we get to travel, guys.
Right.
But I was surprised. These sisters are a traveling coach.
Everything they do, they make it seem like, oh, yep. We do everything first class. Everything is upgraded. And they probably could fly first class if they sold that luggage full of sunglasses. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I noticed that too. They were like three across, then Georgi.
Mm-hmm.
Could you imagine being on that flight with them?
I would love it because I'm sure they flew out of Hartford, which we fly.
I could see them taking a town car to New York.
I can see them flying.
Maybe to go to Florida. They'd shout out to Bradley, Windsor Locks.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Nice bathrooms.
They just remodeled.
I know.
Yeah. I would lose my mind if I was on that plane, I think.
I don't know what I would do. I think it would be so awesome.
Yeah, it would be. That's the in-flight entertainment.
But it's funny because every time we book tickets to Connecticut, there are always these tickets because you cannot really fly direct to Florida from Connecticut. So there are all these tickets. You can go through Atlanta, you can go through Charlotte, you can go through blah, 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 right?
Sure.
But there are always the tickets that you can go through Miami.
Right. You have to fly past us.
Yes.
And then, yeah.
But hey.
Unnecessary.
Maybe those are the tickets we should be booking because the sisters might be on those flights.
That's true.
They might
something,
be on those
something
flights.
To think about. I mean, we're not that obsessed with them. I mean, kind of.
Kind of.
Not going to fly out of my way to see them. But anyway, okay. They get to Miami. They head to their villa. This place is posh, okay? Mm-hmm. Whatever they saved on their airline tickets, they put into this place because this house looked like what they wanted that Rhode Island house to be like in the first season.
Mm.
When they were
second
in...
Second season.
Was it second?
Georgi.
It was the end of the season was the proposal on the boat.
Oh, you're
right. I think it was first season.
You are...
Because the end of second season was... them breaking up.
You're right.
So this is that house that they were envisioning when they were throwing like the white party, Miami, but they were in Rhode Island. Mm-hmm. This is what they were envisioning. They manifested it and it finally came true.
The garden could have been a little bigger.
The backyard wasn't the best. The backyard at Deb and Reina's restaurant was a better situation. But hey, they're there. They're loving it. Darcey loves the house. She loves the closets. And they're not just for clothes. You know what goes down in there. What goes down in the closets?
Maybe she loves to bang while she's touching all her fancy clothes.
Maybe
they play dress up.
I was thinking maybe they podcast in there because that's where this little podcast started, was in the closet.
That's very true.
Yeah, I was like, what goes down in the strangest thing I've ever done in a closet is podcast.
Very true.
So... okay, they get to the pool in their backyard. They got to de-swell. They're like, we always puff up when we fly. Puffy faces, puffy ankles. We call them cankles. It's like, yeah, so do the other 51 states.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone in America calls them cankles, but they think they coined it. So go with
I've never heard cankles.
Oh, really?
Mm-mm.
Oh, my gosh. Well, good for you.
But when I am on a long flight, my ankles also swell.
Yeah. Happens to the best of us.
Mm-hmm.
So Georgi goes to turn on the hose to cool the pool down. And it's like a Bulgarian boa constrictor out there. Things just starts going nuts, spurting on them.
It's like a snake.
Spraying them. Yeah, boa constrictor. Did I just, Miss Smarty Pants over here, did I just teach you a snake?
Is that a type of a snake?
A boa constrictor. It's one of the most famous snakes. I think so. I'm going to sound like a real idiot.
What?
Yeah.
I would always go for cobra.
You know the snakes you always see people putting around their necks and showing them off on like Hollywood Boulevard and stuff?
Yeah.
Boa constrictors.
I've done it.
You have?
In New York.
I think it was a boa constrictor.
It was yellow.
Yeah, I think so. I could totally be wrong.
I've done it in New
York. Not a fan of snakes.
For $5.
Not a fan of snakes, but that's what it reminded me of. So then Georgi hoses all the ladies down like they're farm animals or something.
That's how we do it in Bulgaria.
And it was a bonding moment. It was a sweet end to a very sweet episode.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what we saw. So good.
So good.
So much
Almost
goodness.
Almost too good.
Loved it.
Loved it.
Loved being back here in person with you to talk about it because it wasn't the same talking about our sisters virtually.
No, it wasn't. Plus, I almost feel like we always have this delay because of the internet and it's just not ideal. You're cracking a joke. I'm talking over you. I'm cracking a joke. You don't hear it. It's like,
Yeah. That's the reason I don't laugh.
Please.
I'm just kidding. Okay. That's it, guys. Thanks for listening. We hope you enjoyed the episode as much as we did. Make sure you follow us on Instagram at Married to Reality Pod. It's where all the good things happen. Make sure you guys follow the podcast wherever you're listening. So easy to do. Just look down and smash that follow button.
Guys, smash it like it's as hot as this freaking episode because it was on fire.
So hot, so hot. And Teresa wants me to mention we have merch at marriedtorealitypodcast.com. And thank you guys again for the reviews. If you haven't left one, please do. Apple, Spotify, wherever else you can leave a review. We love it when you do. So thank you in advance for that. That's all I have to say. I've said it all. You?
Said it all.
Say something in Morse code.
Boo-boo.
Beep, beep. Beep, 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 beep. All right. Now I sound like the Roadrunner.
I think now you really have said it all.
Okay. We'll talk to you guys soon. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.